warm welcome to Inter-School English Parliamentary Debate Competition. We all know that English version and the Samson Hocken School and College is committed to develop students' hidden treasure by arranging huge co-curricular activities. Among them, English Parliamentary Debate Competition is one of the most significant parts. Today's Intra-English Version Debate Competition is going to be held comprising the students of Tulip along with the students of Daffodil of Class 7. Ladies and gentlemen, in this debate, there is a government party and an opposition party. The motion is placed in the House by the Prime Minister, who is also the leader of the House. The role of the opposition is to place constructive arguments against the motion. Today's motion before the House is Mass Awareness Can Stop Corruption.
Paul, thank you all for joining today's session. So first, I would like to request Mr. Tanveer Ahmed Ayaan, the Prime Minister, to start his proceedings.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak before the House about today's motion. Today's motion before the House is Mass Awareness Can Stop the Corruption, and today I am on behalf of today's motion. Now, we as today's government side strongly believe that this is true, but before we come to our actual point argumentation, let us first define some important terms in this debate. So at first, I'm going to talk about the mass. Honorable Speaker, the word mass means involving or affecting a large number of people or thing. Then the word awareness means a state of being conscious of something. More specifically, is the ability to directly know and perceive or to feel or to be cognizant of events. And then the word can means to be able to be or be to be permitted. Then the word stop means came to an end or caused to come to an end. And now comes the most important thing in this debate, which is corruption. Honorable Speaker, the word corruption means a form of dishonesty or criminal offense undertaken by a person or organization entrusted with the position of authority to acquire benefit of or abuse power for one's private gain. Honorable Speaker, day by day that we are getting developed, and Honorable Speaker, the corruption is also getting more and developed and also more and more dangerous. Honorable Speaker, now I would like to come for the present situation of the corruption in our country. Honorable Speaker, at present, the situation of the corruption is much more dangerous than our thinking. Honorable Speaker, at present, there is no sector or there is no country remaining those who are fully free from corruption. Honorable Speaker, now many countries feel that it should be received a highest priority attention in a country's development agenda. This greater recognition that corruption have a serious adverse impact on the development of has been cause for concern among developing countries. In a recent survey of 150 high-level officials from 63rd world countries, the respondents ranked public sector corruption as the most served obstacle in forming or confirming the development as the most served obstacle confronting the development process. Countries in the Asia and Pacific region are also very worried about this problem.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, for your very constructive speech. Now I'd like to request Mr. Ibrahim Zawad, the leader of the opposition.
First of all, a great thanks to Honorable Speaker for giving me a chance to lay before my speech in this floor. So today's motion before the House is Mass Awareness Can Stop Corruption, and we are strongly opposing this motion, Honorable Speaker, because we believe that mass awareness can't stop corruption. Honorable Speaker, me and my team will show you the why mass awareness is ruthless in case of combating corruption. Education means quality, the quality of a person. How does he act or do any unlawful act? Does he refrain from any unlawful acts, activities or orders? Honorable Speaker, if he can do that, then he is not educated, Honorable Speaker. If he has to be educated, then he has to get rid of those acts like efforts, like corruption, Honorable Speaker, or bribery. Otherwise, we won't tell him an educated people, Honorable Speaker. So, Honorable Speaker, now I'm going to describe about reducing discretionary power to combat corruption. So, Honorable Speaker, what's discretionary power? It's power or right to decide according to one's own will and judgment. It's called discretionary power, Honorable Speaker. Honorable Speaker, So how can the discretionary power reduce corruption? Because, Honorable Speaker, when a person is free to decide anything at his will, he will make him overpowered. Now, Speaker, as I said, discretionary power means the power or right to decide according to one's own will and judgment. Honorable Speaker, the judgment or will should be dependent on the highest person of government, like the Prime Minister or the President. But if they are suffering from discretionary power, they will have the power of many things, Honorable Speaker. They won't need to think about the mass people. As he has the power to do anything at his will, he will do whatever he wants, starting from bribery to corruption.
Madam Speaker, in Bangladesh, 35% people is illiterate. They are not educated. Then how my dear opposition team can say that is education quality can stop corruption? Speaker, now I come to my point. Speaker, there is a relation between mass awareness and corruption. Speaker, it's long been recognized that public awareness is a crucial tool in the fight against corruption. Speaker, this recognition is codified in UNCAC, means United Nations Convention Against Corruption. Speaker, public awareness facilitates the reporting of corruption. Speaker, public awareness also helps to increase popular support for government anti-corruption efforts. This function of public awareness has two distinct processes. The first process is to increase knowledge among the populace of government efforts or government anti-corruption efforts and bring notable success. Speaker, mass awareness and responsibility involves the awareness, understanding, and appreciation of connections. Later, please. Involves the awareness, understanding, and appreciation of connections among people. Speaker, if public develop awareness of and take responsibilities for their social, physical, and natural environments by working independently and collaboratively for the benefit of other communities and the environment, thus they can advocate for and act to bring about positive changes.
Honorable Speaker, firstly, I would like to tell about education. Honorable Speaker, with the help of education, we can remove corruption. According to the report by Transparency International, the least corrupted state is Kerala. The reason behind that, Kerala's rate is highest in India. So we can see that how education affects. So, Honorable Speaker, we can see now how education affects, and fairly large number of people are uneducated in most of the states. So, Honorable Speaker, those who are uneducated do not know about the process, provisions, and doesn't get any just. So, corrupt public servants try to make a fool of them and unawareness in the field of law, public places, and common places as well. Honorable Speaker, my next point is that we need to change the government process and keep direct contact between the government and citizens. If the members of the government and government officials, then there will be certainly less corruption. The reverse may be possible only where there is no more criminal politicians in our government. So, Honorable Speaker, the provision is that is there is any case filed against a person who is not eligible for election. But if we see, Honorable Speaker, from 100 politicians, then about 60% of those will have a criminal case against them. If these criminal politicians are in charge of forming and implementing laws, what type of law would be formed? Only one can guess. This during election, we can should keep in mind the persons for whom we shall vote. In India, there is a provision that one person as a criminal should allow a member of parliament of country, and unfortunately, fair large number of this are part of this. But if we talk about Bangladesh, it is not possible. So we can in Bangladesh, we can give it by digitalization. We can reduce corruption by increasing direct contact between government and citizens.
Honorable Speaker, I would like to describe more that firstly, mass awareness helps change culture. It is particularly important with to political corruption, Honorable Speaker, which is too widespread for effective prosecution or by the law enforcement. In the case of small time types of police of the officers, the most effective counter measure may be to educate people to educate people, to alert people, honorable speaker, so that they put themselves, they could prevent themselves to do so, honorable speaker. For this, for that, we need honest, honorable speaker.
My first point is about digitalization, where virtual currency and digital currency. So, honorable speaker, we know that our country and Bangladesh is, our country, Bangladesh, and the whole world is now digitalizing day by day. So, honorable speaker, we can get the facilities of them to remove corruption. So, honorable speaker, the most important thing is that using of digital currency or virtual currency. Honorable speaker, I think that most of us know about this. Honorable speaker, this is already started in China, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, we can also use this in our country. So, honorable speaker, how can we implement this? Honorable speaker, we have to only remove the normal money or the manual money, and we only need a card and a QR code and only bank account, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, a question may come in your mind that how can it remove corruption? So, honorable speaker, I'm going to give you the answer. So, honorable speaker, we know that the most of the corruptors used to use their money without any kind of account. They used to give it hand to hand, honorable speaker. But honorable speaker, if there is no kind of normal money, they must have to use an account for the digital currency, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, when they will give the money to one to another, then it will be counted, honorable speaker. And honorable speaker, in this way, they can be caught.
We talked about that. We also can use the social medias, for example, Facebook, YouTube, to make mass awareness. But honorable speaker, I think that you don't know anything about digitalization. Honorable speaker, this social media, YouTube and other things and media, these are also a part of digitalization. So honorable speaker, he is also talking about our digitalization. So we all must need the digitalization to implement the mass awareness. Honorable speaker, at last I want to say that with the mass awareness, we also need the digitalization and the loss in order. Thank you,
honorable speaker, for again giving me the opportunity. Honorable speaker, in this debate, in this whole debate, our opposition side has talked about many points and also have talked about implementing many points. For example, implementing good judiciary system and lots of things, honorable speaker. Honorable speaker, if we make a budget of this all things for scanning these things, then we will see that it will come a very huge number, honorable speaker. And honorable speaker, and it's clear that right now in this pandemic situation, our government cannot spend this lot of good advantage, a lot of money for these types of things or implementing these things, honorable speaker. Honorable speaker, the points that has been told by them, it will require a huge amount of money. Instead of that, if we implement our mass awareness, it will not require that amount of money, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, they are telling to spend lots of money, honorable speaker, for removing the corruption. But, honorable speaker, we are telling to expend some few amounts of money and which will work properly, honorable speaker. Honorable speaker, their points have a lots of percentage for becoming not work properly, honorable speaker. Honorable speaker, for example, they have talked about digitalizing money and many other things, honorable speaker. But honorable speaker, we know that nowadays hacking is more and more developed, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, more and more you develop each and everything, more and more the hacking will also get developed. So, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, without mass awareness, you cannot stop these things, honorable speaker. On the other hand, honorable speaker, they have talked about making people educated. When a people is educated, then he will be know about his rights and responsibility and each and everything, honorable speaker. But honorable speaker, we know that our country is a poverty-full country, honorable speaker. Here, more than 70 to 60% people are in face of poverty and they are not educated, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, if they are corrupted or they are made corrupted, they will even can't say that they are being corrupted, honorable speaker. So, honorable speaker, for understanding that you are being corrupted, at first you need to be aware, not education, honorable speaker.
So, honorable speaker, thank you again for giving me a chance for a rebuttal session in this debate. And now I'm going to rebuttal the sum of the points of the opposite government side, honorable speaker. So, first of all, they say that mass awareness is enough to combat corruption, honorable speaker. But don't doesn't they know that mass awareness isn't enough? We need a lots of things to combat corruption. With only mass awareness, we can combat corruption, honorable speaker. Honorable speaker, think our transparency level of the government is not that much high. Our laws and orders are not implemented. Our whole country is illiterate without any education. There is no accountable administration. Is it possible to combat corruption, honorable speaker? We can combat corruption with only mass awareness, Honorable Speaker. We need everything instead of it, Honorable Speaker. On the other hand, Honorable Speaker, the second speaker of our government side talked about the talk state that 35% people of our country is illiterate, Honorable Speaker, and that's why we are suffering from corruption. Honorable Speaker, doesn't he mean that due to illiteracy we are suffering from corruption? Yes, Honorable Speaker, and that's why we're talking about increasing education, Honorable Speaker. If our people are literate and educated, they will know about awareness, they will know about mass awareness, they will know about everything. That by this way we can implement mass awareness. Without this, we can't implement mass awareness. So mass awareness isn't a way to combat corruption, Honorable Speaker. On the other hand, Honorable Speaker, the Prime Minister of the government side has talked about digitalization improves hacking, Honorable Speaker. We are not talking about digitalization on hacking, Honorable Speaker. We are talking about digitalization to combat corruption. Honorable Speaker, if we can implement education in a country, then do you think that there will be any illiterate people? And if Honorable Speaker, we know that there are three types of hacking, white hat and the other two types of Honorable Speaker. Among them, one is bad, one is moderate, and one is good hacking. We need good hackers, Honorable Speaker. We don't need bad hackers. And what does bad hackers mean, Honorable Speaker? They are illiterate. They don't have education about the unlawful works, Honorable Speaker. Due to this, they will do hacking, Honorable Speaker. So if we can increase the rate of quality education or education in quality, then we can also detect hacking in while we digitalize our country, Honorable Speaker. And that's how we want to digitalize our country, and that's how we want to combat corruption, Honorable Speaker, and that's why we are debating this motion, Honorable Speaker.